October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and for many, it is a time to celebrate being a survivor, but also a time to remember those who have lost the battle to this horrible disease. Cancer survivors, friends, and family gathered today at the Coosa Valley Medical Center as Pink Hills of Central Alabama brought out the fire trucks for people to sign and to celebrate those who have survived. Terry Vaughn with Coosa Valley Medical Center commented on the event.
So today we're here at Coosa Valley Medical Center, and we have got the Pink Hills Central Alabama that have come out to help us support our breast cancer patients for Breast Cancer Awareness Month. The great thing about these guys is that they don't just support breast cancer awareness, but they support all cancers. So we wanted to have them to come out to help us support all of our patients. We sent out over 200 invitations. We've had a great turnout so far. We are very passionate here at Coosa Valley Medical Center about all of our patients. We are dedicated to supporting our patients in the community. Our hematology oncology department is just one service line that we have. We have a committed dedication to all of our community here at Coosa Valley, and we are very passionate about the care that we give, and we're really excited to have these guys here with us today. So I'm very grateful for what they do to help support breast cancer patients and all cancer patients in general.
Ronald Moorhead talked about the fire trucks and the significance of the names on the trucks.
All of our vehicles are named for someone who's inspired us along the way. This particular truck's Diane. It was named for a lady that formerly worked for the city of Pelham. She had cancer and succumbed to her cancer eventually. The city of Pelham donated the truck, and in honor of her, we named the truck after her. Melissa is our other truck that's here today. We had a donor purchase it and donate it to us. Melissa was named for the daughter of one of our founding members. She had non-Hodgkin's lymphoma when she was in her late teens, early 20s, while she was in college. She beat cancer, went on to finish her college education, has her PhD, and is now working in research.
And looking at these trucks, there are a lot of names. And have y'all ever just tried to guess how many people have signed this truck?
Honestly, we lost count long ago. And yeah, the numbers are great, but it shows how many people really and truthfully are affected by cancer.
Reporting from the Marble City of Sylacauga, for TV 24 Primetime News, I'm Eric Freeman.